Alright guys, we're walking up to one of their main rail yards here, and we're going to take a look at some more locomotives. Yeah, just kind of give you a look around as I walk up here. But it's pretty nice, you know, you can see they got nice paved paths and everything. And the old street lamps. It's just a really cool place. Yeah, they've got some giant locomotives in here and some very cool GM Streamliner trains that we'll take a look at. But it really is a cool place. A really neat place to bring kids to, because they can, there's quite a few of these that you can climb up on and even ring the bell and all that kind of stuff. So that's pretty neat. I think when we get over, we'll go ahead and walk up inside this one. That's one of the largest locomotives. And, so we'll go check that out, maybe take a look inside. Got Wally along for the ride today, checking out some trains. But you can see, they've got this all set up just like a railway platform. It's really nice. They got some benches in here where you can sit down. And there's all sorts of machinery in here. Hey, let's take a look at this 5011 here. Very cool. This says Atchison, Topeka, and Santa Fe. You can read all that. One of the largest non-articulated locomotives ever built. And it's got 74-inch driving wheels. I've looked at this before, but I thought, you know, it's worth another look. Because it's pretty amazing. We'll actually go up inside of it and check it out, maybe even ring the bell here. But man, those wheels are just massive. Here, maybe I'll stand up next to it just to give you the size comparison here. I don't know if you guys can see it behind me, but I mean, I'm 6'1", so I'll give you some idea of the size of those things. I mean, it is just huge. Check it out. It's got a little wear on it, though, these days. But man, that thing is just massive. Look at that. Plates to tell you a little bit more about it. We'll go ahead and walk up in here and take a look at the controls. And if they still got it hooked up, we'll yank on the bell and see what that sounds like. It's a little dark in here, but hopefully it shows up good. There's the road foreman seat, it says, right there. And believe me, I'm no expert on these, so you guys that are watching will know a lot more than I do. But you got your various pressure gauges and that kind of thing. Speed recorder. But they do have little plates here that kind of explain what various controls are and that kind of thing. So it's kind of cool. Hope you can kind of pause that and take a look. And down here you got the firebox door. You can read about that. But you can see just a big heavy door, you know. I can see like they used to have even on old coal furnaces and stuff. Kind of cool. And you have a steam pressure gauge right here. That says signal foam meter. That was made in Chicago, Illinois. That's kind of cool. And more steam heat gauges, that kind of stuff. Kind of cool. And then you got the fireman's control valve down here. Pretty cool. And over here is the fireman's seat, where he would sit. And then you got the brakeman's seat right behind him. But it's pretty cool. And right up here, they got a pull rope, and you can ring that bell. Let's see if you can hear it. Oh, I didn't even. Oh, there. I heard it. But Anyway, these things are pretty cool to look around in. I mean, there's definitely a lot to take in. Very cool. And then back here, you got the big oil tank. Yeah, the little thing tells you a little bit about that. Looks like they got a water cooler there, too. But anyway, I thought you guys would like a look at that. It's pretty cool. We're gonna keep looking around. You can see some of the other passenger cars and things that they have down here. And this is just a huge building that's just chock full of trains. So we're gonna take a look around and see what else they have. Anyway, guys, we'll see you later. Bye.